With me on Skype this morning from Belvoir Lettings, I'm joined by Dorian Gonsalves. Dorian, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
A first half update, Dorian, a strong 6 months here for you. Just talk me through it.
Yeah, so we put out a trading update this morning, which in a nutshell says that we're comfortably ahead of the same period last year, and we're confident about achieving market expectations for the full year.
Well, it's challenging market conditions out there at the moment, Dorian. What are you putting this strong performance down to?
I think it's when you sort of say challenging, I mean the market is broadly flat. You know, sort of there aren't any more people moving house than there were this time last year. That side of the market is broadly flat, and on the rental side, rents are increasing at sort of 1-2% a year, depending on which index you look at. So again, broadly flat. But underneath that sort of broadly flat sort of backdrop, there are sort of hundreds of thousands of transactions happening. And obviously we're benefiting from taking increased market share.
And the tenant fee ban introduced in June, that's been factored into your numbers?
Certainly has, yeah, and we've had a long lead time to prepare for the tenant fee ban. It was first announced almost 3 years ago, so we've been able to help our franchisees to introduce new income streams such as financial services. You know, that will be significant going forward for us and for our franchisees, and of course landlords will end up paying more money to their agent than they were paying this time last year. And what will happen is eventually that will feed through to higher rents in some areas, not all areas, because rents are very much, they rise and fall in line with local market conditions. And, you know, across the country, rents in some areas are rising, some are falling, exactly the same with house prices. But with 300 offices spread across the whole of the UK, that includes Scotland, Northern Ireland and Wales, our risk is just spread across, you know, 300 offices, so we're in good shape.
The new leadership within the Conservative Party, the new housing minister, what are your expectations?
Well, I think expectations and delivery are always want to be debated. And I mean, actually, in terms of housing, I'm very optimistic, I think, is the general view. Boris is a landlord and clearly understands the sector and has got a fairly good track record with dealing with social housing, which is something that hasn't particularly been grasped by previous housing ministers or PMs. The only downside is, if I'm not mistaken, we've had 17 housing ministers in the last 19 years. So you know, a 16-month average term just isn't long enough to get hold of the sort of mechanics of and make changes to the housing market. But you know, the long and the short of it is Brexit, new housing minister, new PM, all of that almost doesn't matter to the man on the ground, because, you know, people, families still need to move house, still need to buy, still need to sell. And of course, there are 13 million people renting in the UK, hence our business just continues to grow.
It was back in November, I believe, you acquired, was it MAB Gloucester?
We did.
How's that business?
It's performing well. So as the trading update says, we're sort of 23% up year on year, and that's like for like. The latest acquisition that we took on, I mean, they're all operating under the Mortgage Advice Bureau brand. And at the end of 2018, we had 123 mortgage advisors. And what we're looking to do is we're looking to have one mortgage advisor covering one, two or three of our 300 branch network. So really giving our clients access to high quality face-to-face mortgage advice. And this is still quite new for us. You know, we're still only really 2.5 years into the sort of foray into mortgages. And we now have 140 mortgage advisors. So we're moving ahead with that very, very strongly.
And what's the focus? What are you working on at the moment as far as the second half of the year is concerned?
Clearly the rollout of financial services. We only started rolling out financial services to our broad range of franchisees in February of this year. So again, that's absolutely work in progress, but all of the signs are very strong and very reassuring. Acquisitions of smaller lettings businesses, again, still going strong. We're about at the halfway point in terms of our target and forecast on acquisitions. So we've got some work to do in the second half of the year, but we're confident we'll sort of meet or exceed what we achieved last year.
Dorian, great to see you. Thanks very much.
Andrew, thank you.